Good morning. Good morning. I'm Jason Higa, CEO of FCH Enterprises Zippy's Restaurants. Thank you for being here today to support our local food industry. We thank you for your calls, your emails to the council. We thank you for your calls, your emails to council members asking them to vote no on Bill 40. They are hearing you. We have 1,000 emails, calls that have been sent in to date, and there's more coming. Bill 40 originally was a reasonable attempt to limit plastic straws, plastic utensils, and plastic takeout bags in restaurants. We did not oppose the original Bill 40. All we asked for was more time to comply. At the last minute, at the 11th hour, without notice, without input, Councilmember Manahan expanded Bill 40 to include all plastics, affecting all Oahu businesses, affecting all food Oahu manufacturers. It was underhanded and undemocratic. No aloha. Bill 40 applies to the plastic wrap around your Spam Musubi, bags for your local bread, toy bags, tofu containers. The list goes on and on. Think local beef, local produce. What happens? What happens to those companies? What happens to those industries? Even Kapuna Meal Service that wrap their prepared food trays in plastic, no more. And what about mainline companies? Will they be impacted? No. They get an unfair advantage. Mainland chip manufacturers, mainland meat, all imported goods will continue to bring plastics into our islands, while local companies have to raise prices, cut jobs, and even close their doors. Surfrider Foundation and other proponents of Bill 40 say local companies are greedy. We are profit driven. You know the truth. We buy local beef, local produce, local eggs, local tofu, all at higher cost because it's the right thing to do. We support reasonable movement towards the elimination of single-use plastic. Zippy's eliminated our styrofoam in 2010, years before a ban was even considered. We have new compostable chili bowls, and we are just one example of many within our food industry community that has always making steps to do what's right for the environment. We do these things even at a greater cost because it's the right thing to do. So being here today is not about saving money. It's about Bill 40 and the consequences it will have on local business. The exemption that Councilmember Manahan says will protect us is Shibai. It will require companies to apply for exemptions on multiple products. Zippy's Restaurants, our catering, our food solutions, our Napoleon Bakery has over 200 possible exemptions that we would have to apply for. Hawaiian Host, over 250 exemptions. We're talking tens of thousands of exemptions. How will the city handle this process? Bill 40 will kill local jobs and ensure that only mainland companies can survive on Oahu. We are asking you to make your voice heard. Keep calling, keep emailing, keep the pressure on the council members. Ask them to vote no on Bill 40. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Janai Wall, and I'm the CEO of Foodland. As a local company that's been in business for more than 70 years, we, like the other companies here, the other local companies, care about our environment. This is our home, and we want to make sure that Hawaii is here for many generations to come. Yeah. Yeah. We, like others, have not opposed a bill like this before. We believe in being responsible. We believe in making every effort to ensure that we are good members of the community. And like Jason, when he talked about the things we're doing at Zippy's, we have tried to encourage our customers to be environmentally responsible. We've made changes to the products in our stores so that we can ensure that we do our part to protect the environment. And we've, in fact, supported some of the organizations that are proponents of this bill because we believe in the spirit of what they were trying to accomplish for Hawaii. But Bill 40 has gone too far. When the changes were made to make it a total ban on all plastics and to hurt local companies, we needed to speak out. And thank you. None of us can simply stand by and let this bill put local companies out of business. If you walk through our stores, you'll see you would have no ice, you would have no poi, you would have no local tofu, you would have no local chips, no bread, no milk, a lot of those things that we care about and our customers we know very much care about. And that those would go away. The local companies that produce those items are companies that we have tried to support. Buying local is important to us. It's important to our community. And I believe that the local products we offer here in Hawaii are part of what makes us special. It sets our community apart, it makes us different, and we cannot allow this bill to take those items away. Yeah! Yeah! Now, the council members talk about exemptions, and they say we can apply for an exemption for this or that, and Jason talked about Zippy's alone would have more than 200 exemptions they would have to apply for. Now, I don't know about you, but we have struggles even getting a building permit. How are we ever going to get an exemption? So I encourage you to support us in supporting local. Keep the local companies here. Keep the products that you want that come from these local suppliers on our shelves and help us encourage the City Council to vote no on this bill. Email, call, do whatever it takes, but we've got to kill Bill 40. Thank you.
Aloha. My name is Mike Irish, CEO of Homs Enterprise, which makes all the kimchi's in Hawaii. Keoki's Lawa and Kalua Pig, and Diamond Head Seafood. And thank you. We are here to let you know that from the manufacturers, you've heard from the restaurants, you've heard from the retail. I'm going to tell you about the manufacturers. Hawaii food manufacturing industry was not informed. Hawaii Manufacturers Association was not informed. They just decided to ramroll this bill into us and added the wordage that would cut all plastic. But it doesn't stop the mainland people. The food manufacturers in Hawaii do about 3% of all the manufactured goods that come into Hawaii. So you are telling us that The 97% can use their Lay's potato chips and so forth, but our own potato chip companies, our own kimchi companies, our own lala, we can't use our own plastic, and we have to go to the mainland and make our product and bring it in. And even more so, if you read the bill, please read the bill. At the bottom of the bill, I find this ironic, that the people that are going to enforce this is HPD. Our own police force is going to, like, we don't have enough problems with homeless, robberies, break-ins to cars. Now we want to add this onto them and have them do this. This bill is unfair to all local businesses. It's unfair to Hawaii, to all of us who love our food. So please, thank you. Thank all of you for being here today to show your support. I've never seen this many CEOs in one place at one time. Phenomenal. Thank you very much. And a lot of you that are here today, thank you all. And let's kill Bill 40.
We met recently with Councilmember Manahan, Councilmember Waters. They're not ready to listen to us. We need you to continue to call, to email. Let your voice be heard. If you care about local, call. Thank you.
Me to wrap this up, ladies and gentlemen. I can't thank you on behalf of all facets of our industry. I can't tell you how much we are working this hard for the people of Hawaii to ensure them food safety, the best quality food, at the best possible price. So I want to thank you all for being here. You made a tremendous impact. Again, we need to go further with this. Call your city councils, email them, flood them with whatever we can, because we can't have this bill moving forward. So thank you for coming today, ladies and gentlemen. We appreciate it, all of your support. Take care and have a great holiday.
Don't let him speak. You want to let him speak?